technology essentially enables you to be more productive. So if you want to think of producing output, you have some labor, and technology multiplies that labor. And I'm going to call that enabling. It enables you to be more productive in the tasks that you were performing before. And many technologies fit into that category. If you have a computerized design machine, computer-assisted design machine, a CAD machine, you're making your designer more productive. He can or she can draw things to a greater degree of precision. But many technologies are different than that. They actually replace workers in the tasks that they were previously performing. So think of output as consisting of many tasks. So if you want to produce a piece of garment, you need to do spinning, weaving, carding, drawing, coloring, marketing, designing, and all of these tasks. And together, that brings you a t-shirt. Then one of the things that technology does is that it automates some of these tasks. You know, go back to the beginning of the British Industrial Revolution, all of these tasks, some of them did not exist, and that's important, I'm going to come back to that. But all of the tasks that existed were performed by skilled artisans. But then we started introducing machines. First automated spinning, then automated weaving, then further automated spinning, and so on and so forth. So one of the things is we do is that we can achieve cost reductions by performing certain tasks by machines, automating them. Now, many of the important technologies, AI included, automated self-driverless cars included, are examples of this type of displacing machines. Perhaps one of the most remarkable ones are the industrial robots. Here is a Hyundai factory, and the thing that's absent here are line workers. They've all been replaced because all of the tasks that involved welding, painting, connecting, and assembling, etc., they're all now being done by these automated, multi-purpose, reprogrammable machines. And then in many other occupations, in many other sort of industries, you see the same thing. Now, why is it important to draw a distinction between enabling and replacing technologies? I will argue it's crucial both because of their labor market implications and also because of bringing the relationship between productivity and the labor market into tighter focus. So one of the main contrasts is that if you think of technologies as just enabling you to be more productive, it implies it will always help workers. So we introduce a new machine, it helps workers who are college graduates, it may or may not help high school graduates, college graduates earn more, high school graduates earn what they were earning before, perhaps they earn a little bit more, but everybody benefits. There might be some greater inequality if the productivity implications are different, but everybody benefits. That's no longer true with replacing technologies. In particular, replacing technologies can reduce the wages of some subgroups of workers, and even of all workers combined together, as we have seen in the US data. And the reason for that is precisely because they are displacing, they're replacing workers in the tasks that they were performing before. So the first reason, the first impact of a replacing technology when they automate tasks that existed before and that that were performed by labor before, that is that they displace these workers. But that's not the end of the story. If that were the end of the story, that would really be a sad story. Workers would always be harmed by technological progress, or at least technological progress of this sort, and we couldn't really make sense of 200 years of history in which we've seen many examples of these types of automation replacing technologies. And the reason why it's not so, it's not the end of the story, is because these technologies are doing one other thing. You know, the industrial robots, they're displacing the line workers that were assembling the cars. But they're doing that precisely because they are lower cost. They enable firms to be more productive and achieve lower cost. But when the firms do that, they expand production, so they want to have more of the workers that have not been automated yet. So you're going to have more non-production workers, more design workers, more engineers, and more of the production workers for the tasks that have not been automated. So this productivity effect and the displacement effect go together. So now we have a holistic picture of how employment implications of technology are forming. And that immediately implies one important conclusion that's not always noted or understood in popular discussions. What you have to fear, actually, isn't the brilliant technologies that are so productive that they are going to completely replace workers. What you have to fear are the technologies that are so-so, They are just enough to automate existing tasks, but not so much better than humans that they are not capable of creating a powerful productivity effect.